Hello and welcome to a spirited debate. I'm Lauren Green. The massacre in Orlando, Florida, by a man who pledged his allegiance to the Islamic State, has re-intensified the focus on mosques in America. Reports say that Omar Mateen had been enrolled in the online Fundamental Islamic Seminary, Knowledge Seminary, run by a former prison inmate. With more on the seminary and other mosque connections to terror is Pamela Geller. She's the president of the American Freedom Defense Initiative. Welcome.
Thank you for having me.
So what do you know about this Fundamental Islamic Knowledge Seminary at all?
This was a school, an Islamic center, started by Abu Taba, previously known as Dwayne Robinson, who, it was not an Islamic learning center. I mean, maybe, of course it was, but it really was a center for jihad incitement. He preached against homosexuals. He called for the slaughter of homosexuals. This was a convicted criminal who used the proceeds of his robberies, over $300,000, gave it to mosques, because that's what you need to do to cleanse the money under Islam. And he used that seminary as a springboard to give lectures across the country. They had to separate him from the prison population because he was radicalizing converts in the prison. He was the imam for the Islamic Center of Orlando. He wielded enormous influence. These are mosques that must be shut down.
Why wouldn't the FBI be alerted to this? Or perhaps they were and they did nothing, or they said he wasn't a threat. What happened with the authorities in this Islamic center?
Well, as you know, Islamic supremacist groups, groups like the unindicted co-conspirator in the largest terrorist funding trial, CARE, have been working furiously to dismantle counter-terror programs. No surveilling of mosques. Now, we know over the past 10 years there have been three separate surveys of mosques. Each one independently showed that 80% of the mosques in America are teaching, preaching, and inciting to jihad. The problem...
80%?
80%. We have a Sufi imam who actually surveilled 114 mosques and testified before the State Department. We have the Center for Religious Studies, and we have the Dr. Mordechai Kedar and David Yerushalmi had conducted an empirical study, and they all came out the exact same way. The problem is no one has declared war on the jihadic doctrine. Mm-hmm. And if you've declared war on the jihadic doctrine, and those that are inciting to sedition, inciting to treason, you could prosecute. But what are you going to prosecute? They call it freedom of religion, when in fact it's not the religious aspect that any of us care about. It's the political aspect.
Right. You know, lately the President Obama and Donald Trump have been getting into this trash talk about what do you call the terrorists? Can you say the words radical Islam or Islamic radicals? Because he has not said those words. Do you fault him for that, or does it make any difference?
It makes an enormous amount of difference. I mean, should we not have used the word Nazism? You know, I mean, how can you possibly address a problem if you refuse to identify the problem? Obama has consistently sided with the jihad force. Look, he says that we need to do soul searching. We have to do some soul searching. The victims have to do some soul searching. I submit to you, it's the Islamic world that has to do some soul searching. He never calls upon the Islamic world about the creed apartheid. Christians have been systematically exterminated now. There's a genocide in the Middle East. I've never heard him speak of it. Creed apartheid, gender apartheid, Islamic Jew hatred. He never speaks to this. And to suggest that there's no motive or the motive doesn't matter is the reason why we're in the fix that we are in right now.
You know, one of the things, though, that Donald Trump is being criticized about extensively is this call for, you know, banning Muslims from this country. I mean, but Omar Mateen, he was born here. It was, even if you did that, it still wouldn't have affected him at all. So that's not even realistic.
Well, it's not realistic in the scheme of things right now, but I think it's a very realistic approach. His father is a Taliban supporter, and yet he was hobnobbing in the hallowed halls of Hillary's State Department. The father should never have been brought here. You cannot bring Muslims from Afghanistan here when, according to a Pew poll, this is Pew, 99% of Afghan Muslims support the Sharia, the most brutal and extreme ideology on the face of the earth. He's right. You can't import. They're coming to this country with a ready-made model of society that they believe to be superior to our law, and they seek to impose it. Why would you import that?
All right. I want to thank you so much, Pamela Geller. And for more information, you can go to PamelaGeller.com.
Thank you.
On this and FoxNews.com. This has been a Spirit Debate. Thanks for watching.